weeks ago, protesters shut down I-35, as you might remember. Now they have their eyes set on the Mall of America on one of the busiest shopping days of the year.
The group is part of the Black Lives Matter national movement, but the mall is private property, and MOA officials are warning any protester who steps inside on Saturday might be leaving in handcuffs. KARE 11's Melissa Colorado joins us now with more on what the protesters are planning for tomorrow.
Good morning, Carla, and that's exactly the warning that protesters are getting. Now, protesters are counting on the Mall of America to be packed tomorrow afternoon. They're expecting to protest at the mall's rotunda starting at 2 p.m. Now, protesters are defying the Mall of America's long-standing policy: no protests or demonstrations on mall property. In fact, the Minnesota Supreme Court backed up that policy in a 1999 ruling, but that's not stopping the local chapter of the group Black Lives Matter. So far, more than 2,600 people have signed up on Facebook to attend tomorrow's protests. The mall and Bloomington police have asked the group to move the protest outside to a public area near the mall, but organizers say no.
And it is partially about disrupting, disrupting your regular day life, because as a Black citizen, your life is disrupted without any sort of warning.
Now, according to Black Lives Matter Minneapolis, Bloomington police have sent officers to the homes of several organizers. The protesters say it is a clear act of intimidation. Bloomington police say they hope protesters move the protest outside to a designated public area where they may conduct it peacefully and legally. Unclear if that is going to happen, because the protest is set for 2 p.m. tomorrow at the Mall of America. Organizers say they are preparing a bail fund for members who are arrested. So it's clearly going to be a very interesting day tomorrow at the Mall of America. Shoppers are going to be packing the stores, and you're going to be seeing likely these protesters there.
And to be clear, this is a consistent policy that they've had since that 1999 ruling with the Supreme Court.
Correct, correct. Yeah. And in fact, Bloomington police say they are going to be adhering to that policy, and it's going to be interesting to see just how many police officers are likely to be out there just making sure that the mall is safe for everybody.
Interesting. Thank you, Melissa.
Stay quiet. Thank you. I appreciate it.